Fuego Sound.
Legs crossed, back straight, eyes closed, breathing in through our noses and out through our mouths. Feeling the power of you controlling your breathing. Knowing, remembering, it's the same power we use to control our thinking. Now use that power. Use your determination to see in your mind today your best effort in all the exercises, stretches, movements we do here together. See in your mind right now, see yourself doing the best you can, giving the best effort you've ever done for anything. Maybe you want to visualize the last time we did these exercises and stretches together. Go there and think right now about what you could do better or differently this time. It's the same process we use to grow our minds and grow the strength and health of our bodies and energy.
We'll be right back.
La ha señalado rápido, claro. ¡Vamos! ¡El tercero!
Morning, guys. You are more powerful than you can ever begin to imagine. Here's the game changer for me. I want to share with you. When I made the decision, the determination, the choice to take everything that has happened in my life, all the failures, all the mistakes, things I don't like, things I got angry about, things that I knew I could change, when I took all that negative energy, stored it up inside, and you can do this too, and made the decision to now transform it into the most beautiful light I can be, it changed everything. And now I'm on this path to infinite mind wealth that I want to share with you openly and honestly. You have that same power, but you got to find it within you. You got to make the determination within you. Have a great day, everybody.
Today's training that I want to lead you through is going to be a little bit different. And I think it's because of where we find ourselves potentially in the world, but also where we might be finding ourselves in different life stages. As you know, for me, we just welcomed another baby. So I'm kind of in this cocooning stage with my family where I just kind of want to figure out our new flow. But maybe you are in a different season of life. Maybe you're going towards retirement. Maybe you're starting a new career. Maybe you're navigating family challenges. Maybe you're caring for parents or elderly. Maybe you're caring for children. I think that we all find ourselves in a unique situation. So first things first, whenever I approach a new year, there is just something so amazing to me about a fresh start. It feels like if you were on Willy Wonka and you got life's golden ticket, like Brendan talks about life's golden ticket, and you're kind of given this clean slate. And I walked in to this new year as a postpartum mom, and we also got COVID. And so right away, initially going into this year, I was like, I could feel derailed within day 7 of 2022 if I allowed it. But when I was thinking about this training and thinking about how I would approach winning the new year, I really had to think about digestible chunks. I need to break things down into smaller sections for me. So if for you, when it comes to looking at this year at a glance, you're feeling overwhelmed by how we're going to tackle the next 365 days, or if at this point, 343 days, whatever we're at, if that feels overwhelming, I want to invite you into a practice that I've started doing. So for me, because of my life with my children, it's really hard for me to be able to even know what next month is going to look like, yet alone what next year will look like. And so when I started thinking about this year, the first thing that I wanted to decide on was a central theme. So how many of you guys have heard people choosing a word for their year? Now, this is a practice that a lot of people do. A lot of people show it. They share their word of the year. Maybe it's for accountability. Maybe it's just to put it out there. And for the last few years, I've chosen different words for the year. Now, it sounds like kind of a weird woo-woo type practice, but what I have found is that it almost lays a foundation for your year so that when you are setting goals or making decisions or navigating different scenarios, you can always come back to that home base. So for example, a few years ago, my word was surrender. We were in our fertility process and just trying to figure out what is this going to look like? And I needed to choose the word surrender. I needed to just surrender to what was going to be. The year after that, we successfully and thankfully had our baby girl, Coco. My word was presence. I just wanted to be where my feet were. I'm still trying to land on my word for this year, but I think it's something along the lines of intuition. I need to follow my gut, to trust my gut. So when you think about the year, I really think it is helpful to choose a theme. This is going to be your foundation. This is going to be that place where you go, is this aligned with surrendering? Is this aligned with presence? Is this respecting my goal for trusting my intuition or my gut? And the thing that I also want to note is if you had a word of the year for last year and you felt like maybe you got derailed or wasn't a success or you didn't quite win it, carry that word forward. That word can still serve you and serve as that base. There's no need to change it if that word is still working. So what I want for you to think about is how can we create a foundation, lay a foundation that has a feeling? So when I look at a lot of people and their goal setting practices, it's beautiful. They have these tactical things that they want to achieve within the next year. But a lot of times they don't actually think about how is this going to feel? How is this goal going to feel when I accomplish it? How is the pursuit of this goal going to feel? And what I found is that having that theme or that word, it gives me that feeling to really check myself and my alignment. Now, I want to share something that I am working on this year. I haven't shared it publicly anywhere, but it's something that I have recognized in myself as I've kind of evaluated last year moving into this year, is that I am actually aiming for more gray areas in my life. And let me explain this. I am an all or nothing kind of gal. I am either all in, gung-ho, full force, show me what I need to do and I'll do it, or I'm a nothing. And I've recognized over the last year that as I set goals, I tend to be very extreme. I don't know if anyone else resonates with this, but I am like, I am all in, I will not eat any sugar for 30 days and blah, 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 blah. And then the second I fall off, I'm a nothing. And so what I am trying for as an achiever, as someone who is striving to grow, to learn, to move, to navigate, is that I am aiming for more gray areas this year. And maybe that gives you a little bit of peace. Maybe that gives you anxiety, depending on where you fall on the spectrum. For me, I want to find more fluidity in my year. I want to find more room for grace, like Glo was talking about, but also just recognize that when it comes to things that maybe served me in the past, like certain boundaries or relationships, that I can find that area of gray that allows me to continue to strive to do better, but also doesn't derail me the second I fall off. I recently was on a phone call with a dietitian because one of my goals for this year is to feel vibrant. It's not to lose 10 pounds or to get back to my pre-baby weight or anything like that. It's to feel vibrant. And I was on the phone with a dietitian and I said something about Cheetos and I was like, oh, I love Cheetos. Like me and Coco, we can smash a bag of Cheetos. And I was saying how it wasn't a good food. And she goes, I don't want for you to look at things as good or bad. I want for you to think of things as optimal or less optimal. You have a less optimal snack, that's okay. Move on to an optimal one. Make a choice instead of looking at things as bad or good. And it really helped for me to think about how do I want to ground myself in gray this year in that I can continue to progress, but I'm not going to beat myself up or freeze the second that I stop or mess up. And so I want for you to just think about what that looks like for you. And that brings me to my next point. One of the things that I think we often fail at when it looks at goal setting or attacking a new year or setting resolutions is that we don't do it from a place of self-awareness. Now, I know a lot of things about you simply by you being here today, by joining this platform. You know that you want to grow. You know that you're willing to invest in personal development. You know that you need mentors. You know that you want to pour into yourself to move forward. But what I have found is that when we lack self-awareness, when we lack truly knowing ourselves, we create goals that don't serve us or our lives, but we also approach them in a way that makes it nearly impossible for us to follow through. So when I was thinking about setting goals for this year, I did it from this place of self-awareness. So my awareness was grounded in the fact that a lot of us are merely exhausted. We are 2+ years into a world that constantly is changing and shifting. We don't necessarily feel grounded in knowing what is next from a worldly standpoint. And so we struggle to choose what's next from a self standpoint. And my self-awareness was telling me that because I feel that level of uncertainty, I struggle in visualizing a year out from now. And so when I set my goals this year, I wanted to do it from a place that honored who I am and where I'm at in this season. For example, Brendan is remarkable at teaching morning routines. So good. I hear morning routines and I'm like, yes, that sounds amazing. I would love to sit down with a journal and a hot cup of tea and take in the view. But I am aware enough of the season of life that I'm in that right now I need more sleep than that morning slowdown. It's just not necessarily feasible where I'm at with two little kids. And so I might not be a morning routine person, but I am really good at boundaries. So when I set my goals, how can I set them in a way that honors the things that I'm good at, which are boundaries and microscopic movements forward in honoring that, like, progress is progress, even if it's small.
Good header forward by Xavi. Onto it here is Lionel Messi. Wonderful finish.
Morning, guys. Today we're introduced to Jack Ma in our top 10 rules for success. And his introductory cover there, I love his quote, what he says. He says, "The secret code for everyone is to keep your dream alive because you never know when it might come true." I love this. This is what we are meant to do. We are meant to dream. We are meant to be larger than our physical limitations. We've got that stored energy inside that is yearning, crying for more. We have that ability to take what we don't like, what we want more of, and slowly but surely work towards it. So here's Jack Ma, who has proven, even in a country like China, where entrepreneurship wasn't what it was today, and he's one of the ones that has started that path, and he's inspired so many. So hopefully this inspires you. Have a great day, everybody.
The fastest way to change your habits is to change your environment. You ever notice how when you're in a different environment, maybe you go on vacation, maybe you go to an event or a seminar, you start doing different things? You are still you, and you do some of the things that you used to do, but all of a sudden you're doing new things that become a part of your regular routine. You ever been away for a couple weeks and discover that you've built up some new habits, and maybe some are healthy, maybe some are unhealthy? And so if you want to be able to switch your habits quickly, you change your environments. Now, you may not always be able to go on vacation or go to events or seminars, so those are options. But it starts with you figuring out, well, what are the habits that you want to develop? Who are the people that you want to be around? And when you are around those people, you will start to think differently, which will lead to you behaving differently. When you see other people doing it, you're going to want to do it more. When it's in your environment more, you're going to want to do it more too.
Hey, it's Nina Carmichael, and we made these videos because you're probably the most ambitious person in your circle, but you know you're capable of more. And you need the push by surrounding yourself with the best. So today, let's learn from one of the best, my husband, Evan Carmichael, and learn the fastest way to change your bad habits. Enjoy.
This morning, I was talking to a YouTuber, big YouTuber, bigger than me, more subscribers than me, slightly different niche. And I remember meeting him in California a couple years ago. And one of the things he was struggling with was staying consistent. And I'm very consistent. And one of the things I was struggling with was staying healthy while I was on the road. And we were having dinner together, and he was eating super clean. He was eating fish and salad, and I probably had a burger or something, fries. And coming away from that, what I realized was whoever is more confident wins. And when you're around other people, whoever's more confident in the habit that they have will be the dominant habit that both of you end up picking up. So if we were hanging out together more, here's what would happen. I would become a lot healthier in my eating, and he would become a lot more consistent in his content, because we'd be inspired by each other. Because he'd see me working away, make my videos, and he'd feel bad that he wasn't making his, and he'd have to go and start making his. And I see him eating healthy all the time and be like, man, I should be eating healthy. And it would force me to do it as well. That environment switch would allow us to create much better, stronger habits. So now you gotta be careful about the kind of people who you're hanging out with. And if you look at the people you've got right now around you, chances are they're keeping you stuck, they're keeping you small, they're keeping you where you are. And you're probably pouring into them, right? You're the one giving them love, giving them encouragement, giving them support. Pouring into them. You're taking your cup and pouring into them. And it's great. And you should keep doing that. And it's amazing. And it's fulfilling. But who's pouring into you? And who's making you get to the next step? Because if you don't have that, you're gonna continue to stay small or just have slow growth compared to where you could be. So how do we get some practical steps? Okay, that's great. What do we actually do? How do you start making that change happen? Well, the first step is to figure out what is it that you want to get better at. You know, what area of your life or business do you want to be better at? Is it you want to stay more consistent on your habits? You want to learn how to make money? You want to have a better relationship? You want to take care of your health? Like, what is the thing that you actually want to get better at? Getting clarity on what that thing is. Two is to then surround yourself as much as possible with content, not even people, because it could be great to say, hey, awesome, hang around Joe Dispenza all the time and you will become better, you will meditate more, you will solve your problem, awesome, but you don't know Joe Dispenza, and he's probably not taking on students right now, or mentees, right, or Elon Musk, or Oprah Winfrey, whoever, right? you don't know them, and so that's not a practical answer, but you can hang around their content. It's why I make these videos every day, because if every day there was a new video for you, hopefully it lifts you to bring some of the best experts in the world, the people that I find inspiring and learn from, to share their message every morning. You don't have that person in your life, but there's videos for you. So step two is, so step one, we're figuring out what is it that we want, right? Where do we want to improve and get better? Step two is, who are the people who are living it, who are preaching it, who are living it, who actually inspire you? And there's so many different people out there who are doing it, and everybody has their own way. I like to say that, you know, an Eric Thomas is going to yell at you through it, and Oprah Winfrey is going to hug you through it, but they have very similar messages. Whoever style you connect with the most, have that more consistently in your environment. Follow them on Instagram, subscribe to them on YouTube, put their quotes on the wall around you, create your own environment of the people who make you feel like you want to do more, who inspire you to step out of your comfort zone and take on those new habits that you want to actually adopt, right? So you're creating a new environment for yourself without having to go live with Joe Dispenza or Elon Musk or Oprah Winfrey. Okay, so I call them aspirational mentors, and it, that can be fundamental, and that's where most people need to start, because you have access to their books and their videos and their content. You have that access right now, and that can make a big shift in you if you start surrounding yourself with it every day. And then step three is to get more in-person connections, and this is more time-consuming and more challenging and harder to find the right fits, but can make a big shift as well in your life. So I don't want to only rely on it. That's why step two is actually having just content that you're learning from. But step three, if there's people that you're learning from, do they have an event? Do they have something coming up? Can you hang around people who are like-minded, who are also taking on challenges? I'm doing a challenge right now inside my Movement Makers program, where Movement Makers is for thought leaders who are trying to get to the next level with their content and break through and have a greater message and reach more people. But a lot of people haven't been as consistent as they should have. Because they're the only ones doing this. They don't know anybody else making content. Their family thinks they're crazy. Like, why are you making another video? They're not seeing results. They don't have a peer group. They don't have anybody to connect with and talk to. And this can relate to any goal that you have. Movement Makers is just for kind of thought leaders making content. But whatever goal that you have, if you're the only one that you know who's doing it, it's really hard to stay consistent on it. So our Movement Makers challenge is, every month we have a challenge where you have to make a lead magnet for your business, a solo video, and then three collaboration videos with other people in the group. So it forces you to start making content. And for a lot of the members, this is the most consistent they've ever been now in making content, because one, they're doing it together. You feel like you're doing it with other people, even though a lot of the content that you make outside will still be separate from the members. You're not doing a business together, but it feels like they're connected. We're taking on this challenge together. And then in the collaboration videos, you're connecting with people. You're doing interviews with people. You're sharing your thoughts and feedback. It's not just you talking to a camera in the car with your dogs by yourself anymore. And that really, 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 really matters. It really matters. So getting some kind of support group, connecting with other people who are on the same journey, going to seminars or events, of humans that you can talk to and connect with who are doing the thing that you want to do. Because the more that you're around those people, the more you're going to stay consistent on the habits that you want to build. So using that three-step process can absolutely change your life. It's entirely possible. And if you're watching videos like this, you're already on the growth mindset journey, right? You're already into personal development. You already know you want to do more and serve more and help more. And this helps you elevate yourself to the next level, because you are probably the most ambitious person that you know, that you're hanging out with. And that's a great place to be, because you're serving and helping, but it also sucks because it limits your growth of what you could become. Where if you can, one, clearly identify what you want to change, what is the habit that you want to take on? Where are you not satisfied anymore in your life? Not beating yourself up and saying you suck, but like the next level of growth that you want to accomplish for yourself. And then two, following people just through content who are living that message, who are not just speaking it, but living it, who when you watch their videos, you actually get inspired to go make a change in your life. Who are those people? Subscribe to them, follow them every day, watch their content, read their books, put their stuff up on your wall as a reminder. You're creating a new environment for yourself. And then three is actually connecting with humans, joining a group like Mover Makers or something else, going to events where your tribe is at so that you are not alone doing this journey, feeling isolated and like you don't belong. Make those three changes. It will change your life. The difference between where you are now, where you could be, is just the consistent habits that you're putting in. You know this. I know you know this. Now it's about taking the actual action to stay consistent on those habits.
Rule number two, become efficient.
The number one rule, if you want to make more money, is you have to bring more value. Want to make money quickly? Provide value quickly. Want to make tons of money? Provide tons of value. If you are not making money yet, it's because people don't see the value that you bring. And we're going to change that in this video. So one of the first people that I had any kind of arrangement with on the top 10 series that I had on my channel was Tony Robbins. I made a video on Tony Robbins, I don't know how many years ago now, the first top 10 that I did on him, and his team put it on his YouTube channel. So it may still be there. If you go to his YouTube channel and then look at the playlist, you'll see that one of those videos is the video that I made on him so many years back. And I started trying to bring as much value to his team as possible. Now, Tony's a really busy guy. I'd loved him from all the books that he's written and the CD programs that I listened to. I hadn't been to an event yet at that point. And I was just trying to bring value to Tony's team. I didn't know him personally yet. And it frustrated me that he wasn't more on YouTube. And I thought, hey, this guy needs to be more on YouTube. I want more content for my channel. And I think the world needs more amazing speakers and thought leaders out there creating content on YouTube so people can learn. And so I kept in touch with his team and I said, hey, I'd love to help promote Tony. I'd love to help you with your YouTube channel. I'd love to have Tony on my channel. And I just kept trying to find ways to bring value to his team consistently and following up. And finally, here's what happened. Finally, they agreed, hey, yeah, let's have Tony come and do an interview on your team. And finally they said, hey, let's have Tony come and do an interview on your channel. And I was so excited. I was super nervous to have Tony Robbins on my channel. It's gonna be a big deal. And then like the day of or the day before, he had to cancel. For something happened, something came up on his schedule. No problem, he had to cancel. And all of the nerves and energy is like, oh no, now led to disappointment that is finally gonna happen and then it's not gonna happen. And he said, we'll try to book it in as soon as possible to get it happening because Tony wants to be on your channel. Great. It took 2 years before we actually got Tony on the channel afterwards. 2 years. And that's not to throw shade at Tony. I love him. He's busy. He's doing his own thing. I wasn't bringing enough value to make it sooner. But what I did was I kept in touch. I kept following up, not just saying, hey, is Tony ready yet? Hey, is Tony ready yet? Hey, is Tony ready yet? No, I'm bringing value. I'm helping them with their YouTube channel. I'm giving them suggestions. I'm helping promote their events. I was doing stuff to try to still be in the circle, to stay top of mind, so that when the next opportunity came up, which happened to be when he launched his next book, to say, I want to be top of mind. And Tony agreed to do 5 different remote interviews for his new book. And I was one of the 5. And his team said, you've been so valuable to us. You've been helping us so much. We appreciate it. We want you to be one of the 5 that Tony does an interview with. Like, it's happening. pinch me for real this time. I hope it's happening. And then the day of, he showed up and I was super stressed out and nervous about asking the right questions and trying to bring value again. I don't want to disappoint people. And it went. He showed up. It went great. We had an awesome interview. And at the end, he then said, hey, Evan, I'd like to invite you as my guest to my next seminar, which is coming up in New Jersey, Unleash the Power Within. And he invited me to like front row seats, special lounge access and all the perks, meet him backstage because he wanted to chat and take a picture, which then led to more events and other opportunities and then speaking and then, you know, connecting with Brendan Burchard's team and like lots of stuff happened through the Tony Robbins world and connection. Because I stayed and I followed up because I kept trying to bring value. And even after the first time when they got the cancellation on me, I still followed up for 2 more years and kept providing value for 2 more years, right? It's dog on the bone. I want this to work. I'm going to find another way through until finally it did. And then things took off. And so the same thing for you and your business. If you want to have success, it's about thinking about ways you can provide more value. It's not that you can't provide value. It's not that you're not talented and that you're not a genius. You are. People just don't recognize the value that you can bring yet. And you haven't figured out how to bring that to market in a way that you're going to get paid to do it. Okay, so my 3-step process so that you can provide more value and get paid what you're worth. Let's go. Step number one is build your top 50 list. Think about who are the 50 people that if they knew you, if they liked you, if they trusted you, if they respected you, if they recognized who you were and knew what you were up to, that would mean something, right? For a lot of people, it doesn't matter if they know you or not. They're not gonna be a referral source. They're not gonna be a partner for you. But who are the 50 people that matter most, that you would love to have as dream clients or dream partnerships? Build that list of 50 people that you wanna make contact with. Step number two is be their chief goal officer. If you wanna have success, and this isn't just for the 50 list, but for your clients, for your team, for your relationships, be the person's chief goal officer. When you
It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off of my city, off of my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. Feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. The more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the
disappointing the way the player going forward. Look at this on Messi again, he's through.
Lovely way to pass from Pleb. Brilliant. Absolutely superb.
Good morning, guys. Today I want to share a funny story. I'm sure we've all experienced this, and this is in no way intended to judge or make fun of anyone who might have a fear of our little friends of nature, as I call them, spiders. So it's a story that's been inspired by my daughters, my family. Actually, on the weekend, they saw a spider in the washroom, and they always called Daddy to come and get it. And you know, I'm not one to allow any fear of a little thing like that to stop me. So, but I also make sure that I use the cups of freedom, I call it, to set these friends of nature free. Because when you think about it, there's really no threat to you. They're so tiny. But I laugh, and I want to share this with you, because here's another example of our mind control. So this little thing that it has no power over you, because of the thoughts you have, it affects your fear that you create. So it's just another funny example. Have a great day, everybody.
There was a materially poor man who once approached a sage, some say it was the Buddha, and asked him, "Why am I so poor?" The Buddha answered, "Probably because you don't practice generosity. Probably because you don't practice charity." Amused and a little upset by the response, the man challenged, "Charity? I don't have anything. How can I practice charity?" The sage replied, "Who said you don't have anything? You have 5 treasures with you that you can definitely share with others and give to others. Firstly, you have your smile, which you can share with others. It's free and it's awesome, and it has an amazing impact on others. Secondly, you have your eyes. You can look at others with eyes full of love and concern and make them feel cared for. Third, you have your tongue. With your tongue, you can speak kind, encouraging, appreciative, uplifting words and make people feel valued and inspired. You can spread joy and positivity using your tongue. And then you have your heart. With your loving heart, you can wish well for others and pray for the well-being and happiness of others. And lastly, you possess the treasure of your body. With this body, you can serve others, do good deeds, help people in need. Help is not always money. A small caring gesture can light someone's life up as well. Do these and you'll certainly feel rich. Of course, the message is not that financial resources are not needed. We live in a real world with real needs. Moreover, without caring for ourselves, it's hard to care for others. The message here is that even if we don't have the required resources, we can still be the instruments of doing good in our own ways, according to our own capacities, and make this world a better place than what it is now.
Need motivation?
Watch A Top 10 with Believe Nation.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and I make these videos because I need them. Because I don't always wake up and feel motivated to go take on the day. And the thing that saves me, that helps me every day, is being around people who are thinking bigger, who are changing the world, and it gives me a little more inspiration to go after my mission. And so I hope this video helps you go after yours today too. So today, the song from one of the best, Guru Gopal Das, and my take on his top 50 rules of success. Enjoy.
And that state of hopelessness, if you don't speak up, it leads to further hopelessness. And if you still don't speak up, it can go to further hopelessness. And so bad. I saw my aunt burn herself to death. I saw my friend's son. His medical mark sheet, being topper of the university, kept next to his dead body. Ye log bol paate to? If only they would have opened up their heart and spoken their heart. Well, maybe my aunt would still be with me. Maybe my friend's son would still be doing his postgrad and contributing to the world by healing other people with his medical expertise. I have an humble appeal. Look for that friend. If you have one, blessed are you. Open your heart on a regular basis. If you don't have one, look for one and invest in that relationship.
Meditation is, before bed, my meditation is a gratitude practice.
Like prayer.
Prayer. Every evening before I go to bed, is a practice of gratitude, recounting all the things that happened in the day and being grateful for everything that happened, consciously practicing gratitude. And eventually it just becomes a part of you anyways.
Yeah,
and the first thing in the morning, as soon as I am up, is also beginning my day with gratitude. And then, of course, I have a specific time for meditation as well, which I spend like an hour and a half every day.
If I get to be in front of every kid in every school in the world, Ivan, the one thing that I would like to teach or tell the students who are listening to me is that we cannot go on extreme sides of the spectrum. One extreme of the spectrum is follow your passion, be yourself, correct? Which is what I primarily teach as well. Like what Albert Einstein said, you cannot judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree.
Right.
You know? You can't judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree. Judge the fish by its ability to swim in the water. Okay? Now, two things happen in that case. Number one, the fish is effective in doing what it can do because it's in its right habitat. And number two, it's satisfied because it's in the right habitat. Correct? Put a monkey in the water, the monkey is miserable. Put a fish on the tree, the fish is miserable. Put a monkey on the tree, the monkey achieves excellence. Put a fish in the water, the fish achieves excellence. So I'm one of the proponents. I'm a proponent of this principle that we must definitely encourage our kids to follow their potential and follow their passion. What happens often is we go on such an extreme end of the spectrum that the other side, where what the education system has to offer is there are many good things in the education system as well. So if I were to talk to the students, I would say, let's find that balance. Finding best of both the worlds, you know, grab the best out of what you can have from the education system and let the education system also foster a culture, an ethic, an ethos, you know, where we allow kids to be who they are.
Also, to make sure you're actually taking action after watching this video, I've designed a special free worksheet just for this video. The worksheet will highlight all of the lessons learned in this video, as well as pull out our three favorite learnings and quotes that will inspire you to actually do something. The worksheet will also give you space to write down what your key takeaways are and your specific plan of action to make sure you're getting results. If you want the worksheet designed specifically for this video, absolutely for free, there's a link in the description below. Go click on it and start building the momentum in your life and your business. I'll see you there.
Reading, inspirational.
Here we are again, legs crossed, back straight, eyes closed, deep breaths in through our noses and out through our mouths, the way we began. The way it all begins, always with our thoughts, our powerful minds, which are always subject to our control, no matter how hard it's been to control them. We know the truth, don't we? We saw it today in our effort. We see it every day in life, in the gym of life. We know that we have the power to determine what thoughts we will act upon, and therefore we also have that power to determine what feelings we will allow to flow out and through us. Because our feelings are ultimately connected to our thinking. And if we control our breath with our thoughts, we can always control our thoughts and therefore our feelings. To learn and to grow and to be mind healthy and mind wealthy, peaceful, kind, loving, free, and successful in whatever we do, wherever we are, no matter what. That's why we are already, whether we know it or not, determination. A people, a nation that always has the power to determine, to think, and to be positively, undoubtedly, unwaveringly loving, no matter what. Great job today, everyone. I love you so much. Another great time here together. This is probably one of our last for the summer. I hope you enjoy every moment, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Whether you're in a classroom, at work, at home, wherever you are, enjoy every moment. It's been an absolute pleasure to be with you, to continue growing our minds and our bodies together. But remember the truth, no matter what. Wherever you go, wherever you are already in the gym of life, where you can always grow your mind and your body. I love you. Thank you so much for always, always helping me grow my mind and my body. And may today and everything we've done together, our time together, and wherever you are, with whoever you're with, may that always be an expression of who and what we really are. I love you, everyone. Have a great summer. I will see and connect with you as soon as the time comes. I love you all.